Okay guys, this is going to be flight number 3. Apparently I forgot to hit the record button on flight number 2. But hopefully we got it now. I just wanted to show you where I got my battery placement. I originally CG'd it at that little black mark. But it was a little too tail heavy. It felt good on the CG when you checked it, but as soon as you put it on the ground, it was kind of wanting a tail squat. So I ran it a whole inch forward. I hope you can see this. And it seems to be working. I took the up elevator flap mix out. Doesn't need it. It actually wants to balloon a little bit. So I'm going to fly it now on flight number 3 without any flap to elevator mix. And yeah, so here we go. Let's do flight number 3. The winds have calmed down just a little bit. So hopefully I'll get to feel that glide slope a little better. Because this baby likes to float. It just does not want to land. It just keeps flying. It just does not want to come down. So hopefully now that I've got rid of the up elevator mix on my flaps, hopefully she'll come in on a little bit better glide slope. So let's see how it goes. All right, again. All right, motor's on. Here we go, guys. See that wheeling it's trying to do? Man, she really, for a big jet, it really has a lot of lift. Tons and tons of lift. Got a decent vertical climb, too, for a big 90. And I'm flying at about 6,000 feet above sea level, guys. Here, you can really test. If your plane's, adequate power, at sea level, it's probably going to be a real porker over here. So yeah, flight number 3. Big old reverse Cuban. So I'm flying at high rates. With a 4-point roll there. Don't know how well that came out on camera, but this is about a tick over half throttle right here. And she's still booking, man. She's still booking. I'll try to keep it in close because this run cam, it disappears on a run cam if you get too far away. That's what I've noticed. Yeah, flight number 3. I've got one more battery pack and then I'm done for the day. I only got brought four packs with me. And I love this reverse Cuban on this beast. It's a monster. Alright, let's bring our gear down. Get ready for an approach. I set my timer at 3 minutes, guys, and I'm coming down to between 3.74 and 3.79, depending on the size of the pack. So let's try a little flap. Okay, no pitch. No pitch this time, or no ballooning this time, so that's good. I'm gonna do another half flap. Do another half flap. Come down, baby, come down. There you go. Wow, what a floater. Oh, baby. That was almost like a semi-wheelie landing. I don't know if it showed up on camera, but this thing is going to be real easy to wheelie land. I don't know if it's just the way it's made or what, but what a beast, guys. Thanks for tuning in. I'm loving this new Avios MiG-17 Fresco. Flight number 3, it just keeps getting better and better, guys. If you're on the fence about getting this thing, man, don't play around. Just do it. Click that crazy button. This jet is a great value for what you get for the price. That's why I couldn't pass it up. I had to get it. It is just too cool. Too cool for school. All right, guys, thanks for watching. Thanks for tuning in. Deuces Wild signing.